And it is 1 o'clock, so I didn't mean to interrupt the many conversations that are taking place on the floor, but I'd like to start on time. And I also want to reach out. I know some people are standing. I'd like you please to go to take seats here, if you would, on the floor somewhere. So please, if you would, go and do that. I want you to feel at home here. I do. It's a great place to sit down. If you have not had the opportunity to do it, a great place to make yourself at home. You may never get a chance to do it again. So please take full advantage of it. You know, I like the way people sit over by where the press sits and things. I don't know what this deal is. I'm not going to beg people. Senator Byer, would you please go take a seat, please? He should know better. He's a state senator. He's back there. If someone has your seat, that's unfortunate, Senator Byer. Make yourself at home. Nice to see you, Your Honor. We started 1 minute ago. Nice to see you. Senator Winters, we're letting you come. Yes, Senator Winters, you want to come up here, please? Senator Winters, would you come up here, please?
Yes.
I know. We adults, no worries. We'll get this together here. So I'm Peter Courtney, the presiding officer of the Oregon State Senate, and today we are here to swear in Dallas Lane Hurd to be the, as he informed me moments ago, the youngest member of the Oregon State Senate. I'm sort of sensitive to that. I just wish you had emphasized that. As well as its first millennium. We had to get to there. I don't even know what a millennial is, but not true. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to the Senate Republican leader, probably one of the most respected members of the Oregon State Legislature, the Honorable Senator Jackie Winters.
Well, you know, it's very, very exciting to actually today be a part of this swearing-in ceremony of Dallas Lane Hurd, and along with Dallas Lane Hurd is his wife, Hannah. And I was just reminded that my great-granddaughter, that's her name as well. And then we have with them, it's kind of wonderful, because we were just talking with Ezra, and Eli is here. But, you know, I just think it's always nice, because some of us who are chronologically advantaged, that means both the Senate President and myself, who've been around for a long time, to actually have the millennials and this nice young man who's 33. To give us fresh ideas and new ways of thinking about things. So I am welcoming to the Senate chambers our new senator, and he's going to be sworn in. I understand you can finish some of the remarks, but I spent some time because I think it's important to welcome our new member, but to actually know that our new member brings with him his spouse and his family. We got our welcome already this morning when we walked in the door. Because truly for us here, we know that we cannot be successful without those that are at home supporting us. So I want to welcome also Hannah and Ezra and me. So with that, Mr. President, I'm sure that you have additional remarks to welcome our new senator.
Also, I want to recognize Senator Jack Winters is the Senate Republican leader, but Senator Jenny Burdick is the Senate Democratic leader, and she is also present. As a statement to you, soon-to-be Senator Dallas Lane Hurd, and the respect we have for you and your family in this chamber. I never refer to Senator, this is one of your first lessons you're going to get from me. I never refer to the Senate Democratic leader as the majority leader, and I do not allow the Senate Republican leader to be referred as the minority leader. They are the Senate Republican leader and the Senate Democratic leader, and they have both joined us today to be here to be part of the honor that's coming to you and your families, as well as a statement about the respect they have for this chamber, and that's the way we view our roles here. I'm very jealous of Dallas Lane Hurd because he gets to do something or be something I'm not and never will be able to. He is a native Oregonian. I'd give anything to say I was a native Oregonian. While my wife's a native, our three sons are native, my dog is native, and my grandchildren are native, I don't get to be a native. And he's not only native, apparently he comes from one of the oldest families in Oregon's history, way back 1800. So he truly is a native. His family has been here a long, long time. When he takes the oath today, he will be, as I said, the youngest member of the Oregon State Senate. And as he informed me, and I did not know or think of that at the time, he will be its first millennial. He and his wife Hannah had two sons, Elias, age 4, and Ezra, age 1. Now, I believe I've already met Ezra. I understand they're very active. They have their mother's personality. Because you see, she is the queen. It's an all-male thing, and she's running the show, and that is reflected as Dallas told me through their two sons, so I've had the chance to meet one. He is really he held my hand. He reached out for my hand, and that really got to me, because, I don't know what to do always, but I really feel already that Ezra and I got a little bonding going on. They have a dog. I'm big on dogs. It's a beagle, and it's named Knox. And I've learned more about the dog than I did any other part of the family from Dallas. I don't know what that says about him, but we talked more about the beagle, I think, we did about, I'm just kidding. I'm making it. But almost as much about this beagle that was their first child. And I got to explain that. Apparently, when they got married, right after they got married, they got Knox, who's 9 years old, or 10 or 11 years old, or 10 years at least, he's been married 2 years. And boy, they like this dog. This dog is something else, and the dog's been left alone at home, didn't bring the dog in a day, so of course, we don't allow animals in the building. But I hope that Niles is having a good day, and I'd like to meet him someday. Him or her, I don't know which one, but I'd like to meet him. He started his own business at the age of 4. That's not true. But the way he talks, he's been his own business person since he was 19. He started his own business, he wanted me to know that. And he's been, I wonder what it's like to work for you. I don't know if you have any employees, but you feel very strongly about being an entrepreneur, about being a business person, about doing it his way. He's a licensed landscape contractor, owner of Emerald Lawns. Now I'm gonna tell you something. Dallas Lane Hurd, where are you when I need you? I am so upset. I know Senator Michael Devers looked at me and said, what is Peter going to do here? My backyard, I've been trying to get it tiled for 100 years. I have called the landscape board. I called, would you please get me a landscaper who can tile my backyard? I live in the river because the water's out there. And I can't get one. So Dallas Lane Hurd, I may have to talk to you about my backyard. And I'm serious, because I'm irritated with you landscapers. I can't find you when I need you. He's also a real estate investor. You're a farmer. His parents are Richard and Letha Hurd. And he talked about them in a very affectionate way today. He's very fond of his parents and very close to his parents. And as they say, they come from a long generation of Oregonians. He graduated from Umpqua Valley Christian High School in R-Roseburg. They are the Monarchs. And those who know me, I'm very fond of school colors, and I'm very fond of mascots. So you are the Monarchs. You're 1A, which means when you play football, and you bragged to me about how good you were as an athlete moments ago, he played 8-man football. At least that's what 1A plays. So if you weren't playing 1A, you were in violation of you ever watch the scores of eight-man football, it's like 80 to 70. I mean, there is no defense. They just run up and down the field. I have never seen an eight-man football game, but it is apparently an experience. He has served as the president of Looking Rural Fire District, Looking Glass. Love that name. He was a commissioner of the Douglas County Housing Authority. He was elected to the House of Representatives right through there, where I served many years. I love the House. I adore the Senate. He was elected in 2014 at the age of 29. The guy's a kid. He was re-elected in 2016, and of course now he's here, about to become a state senator. And there he served on the, in the House, as business and labor, higher education and workforce development, energy and environment. And so, it now comes to me to tell you that you're sitting right next to the Chief Justice of the Oregon Supreme Court. You don't have to wave at him. You don't wave at Chief Justice. You don't wave at him. You don't wave at Chief Justice. You got the guy on, you got to be a little different. Justice Thomas Ansel Palmer, and what we'll have is, he is going to administer the oath. So, if you would, you know what to do. Okay, please. So, you're pointing to something.